it's time for a little game I like to call Okay or No-kay. Trending stories that I think deserve some of our attention here on Good Morning Football. And let's start with a guy we all love, D'Angelo Williams. He had a zombie wedding. You heard me right.
Say what?
Steelers running back. Yeah, it was pretty incredible. I guess the day after his wedding, he's obsessed with the walking.
This is great.
Walking Dead, I believe he has. Look how this is so aggressive. It's unbelievable. And they.
So it was his own wedding?
They did a photo shoot. I don't think it was actually on the wedding
That's
date.
That's actually pretty
but
cool, though.
Are we okay with zombie weddings, themed weddings? You guys are three happily married gentlemen.
Wait, the wife was involved on this?
She's the real MVP.
She's the real hero.
What is the theme of the honeymoon? The Saw movies? I mean, that's unbelievably dark.
But they do. I mean, it's a new meaning to death do us part.
It's true. It doesn't do us part, right? Crawls out of the ground. Good job, Kay.
And good morning, football.
I'm leaving it there. Kay, help, please. Thank you. Oh, my God. But I like, though, D'Angelo Williams, if you look at him football-wise, he sort of is the Walking Dead. You kind of keep waiting for him to end and stop, and he keeps crawling out of the ground and having huge seasons. Who are you starting week one for the Steelers? D'Angelo, of course.
He'll be a huge factor.
He's the running dead.
It's a big day, right? You get the beautiful pictures, and then you get something that you really remember for the rest of your life.
Did you guys have a say in your weddings? Were you guys like, I really want to do this?
No. I mean, you show up, you get there at
that's
the altar,
so
you smile, you cut the check,
you slice a cake.
I was a bridezilla. I was all about what kind of chairs, the Shivari chairs, and what kind of salad are we going to have. I want the salad lightly dressed.
Brantzilla.
That wedding video reminds me of Michael Jackson's Thriller video, which you, of course, could see when MTV used to play music videos. Well, good news for you guys. They're launching MTV Classic. It's completely dedicated to the 90s, the whole bit. Music videos, Beavis and Butthead, TRL, and of course, Laguna Beach. Are we okay with bringing back the 90s?
Yeah, I'm huge with it, especially if MTV. The only thing I want them to bring back is the Dan Cortez rock and rock basketball, softball. I want Bill Bellamy out there. I want LL Cool J. I want DeBrat. Those were the best. That's the golden era.
DeBrat, I like that.
Ignore the fact that we could maybe see Real World.
I don't know if anyone knows this. So what's Kyle Brandt, I'm going to tell the audience right now, guys. You can do some Google searches here.
Please,
it was the Chicago season of Real World.
Yes, I was.
And Kyle, I didn't know this until we got here. Kyle was a contestant on the show.
Well, yes, I was.
You
can't be a contestant because we all lose. Trust me, there's no way. A contestant means somebody has to win.
And how was that experience, though?
Oh, thank goodness it was not in the 90s. I was right in 2001, so I don't think I qualify for this. And Peter, we'll talk after the show about
that experience. I don't have to say much about this subject, but you asked if we should bring the 90s back. I got a flat top. Okay, so obviously
they're already back.
I'm living in the 90s.
They're bringing Nintendo back also.
They are.
I'm a huge Punch-Out fan, so I love that. They're getting rid of the VCR, I hear, which is kind of a
VCR is gone. No more videotape.
Speaking of classics, guys, let's talk about 2001's classic hit, A Thousand Miles, by Vanessa Carlton.
Oh, yeah.
The USA Hoops team was on their flight to Houston. I hope we have some
That was
video.
On the movie
this
White Chicks.
Pretty incredible.
Oh, yeah, right.
Jimmy Butler and Kyrie know every word of this song, and they're singing it. There's air piano involved.
I remember that song. She's playing piano on the back of a truck.
Let's play the video.
Let's roll. Let's say, hit it, fellas.
Hit it.
And I need you. And I miss you. And now I wonder.
Yeah, look at Katie. Look at that.
Watch Carmelo here. I love this.
Do you think time will pass me by?
Jimmy Butler's damn.
Watch Carmelo.
Carmelo's having nothing to do with it. Is it okay or no-kay to assume that your business trip flights were all like this?
If I tell you I know the words, I might lose my cool point. So I'm going to just act like I don't know the words.
You already know you know the words.
I know the words. Hey, listen, man, have fun.
I loved it.
Whatever your genre is, I got Britney Spears on my playlist, okay? Let's move on.
One more that the song with her and G-Eazy is fire. One more for today. Last week, the news broke that Anquan Boldin was headed to Detroit, and right away the conversation turned to what will happen to the jersey number.
Yeah.
This is the first thing we talked about.
This was an icebreaker for us.
It's a great conversation
Boldin
to have.
Boldin has worn number 81 his entire 13-year NFL career. That's Megatron's number, obviously, so he decided to go with 80 out of respect for Calvin Johnson. Nate, okay or no-kay to say that you would have done the exact same thing?
100%. Well, I didn't have the type of career that Anquan did, so I wouldn't even have the guts to ask Calvin Johnson for his jersey number, but I love what Kwan did in paying the homage to a guy who's done so much, not only for Detroit, but for the league. And on the flip side, I know Calvin. I honestly believe if Kwan would have asked him and said, listen, I want to wear 81, Calvin would have let him do it. Because
really?
Calvin loves guys like Kwan. And you got to understand, Kwan came in before Calvin. So I guarantee there were years where Calvin looked up to him. And he's been representing for so long.
That's cool.